Hi everyone, let's build our first Maven application. First, what is Maven? Well, I'm glad you asked. Their website claims that Maven is a software project management and comprehension tool. So what exactly does that mean? Well, when you start having medium or large scale applications, there really comes a point at which you need a way to organize and deploy and build your code in particular ways. So tools like Maven are really useful for that. So now that you know what Maven is, how do we use it? Well, let's start with pulling up IntelliJ and seeing if we can make a Maven project within IntelliJ. All right, so here in the new project window, I'm going to say I want to make a Maven project. And instead of using the IntelliJ build system, I want to use the Maven build system. And then if I click on this little advanced settings right here, there's this thing called the group ID and the artifact ID. This group ID looks a lot like a package name. For now, let's just call it that. It's basically how you group your artifacts together. And then the artifact ID, we'll just call the same name as our project. All right, so this is a lot of new stuff. So let's walk through this a little bit. So the first thing is we have an error here, which says that we can't transfer this artifact. We'll get back to that here in a second. But the big thing over here on the left is the project structure. So you'll notice that our Maven project is here. Then we have our source directory, but there's more than just source in here. We have main, Java, our package name, and then our main class. So all in all, the main looks like about what we're used to. If we go over to the resources, there's nothing in here. The resources would represent something that the main code is going to use, but isn't actual source code. So for example, let's say you want to open an image file or something like that. You would put that in these resources. And then you have this test directory, which is a sibling to main. So what the test is used for is when you have test source code, such as unit testing, such as your Java unit tests for your main class, you would include those in here. Currently, I don't have any unit tests, so this directory is empty. And then likewise, if you needed to have any resources for your unit tests, you would include those as source test resources. And then if we scroll down, we have this git ignore, which is a default for when if you're using Git as your revision control system, you can ignore certain files or directories. And then you have this pom.xml. POM stands for Project Object Model, and it's the core of what Maven uses in order to interpret your project. So it's an XML file, which if I minimize a couple of little things here, IntelliJ already populated a lot of this for us. Basically, we have the group ID and artifact ID like we populated within the IDE. And then we have this default version of 1.0 snapshot, which means this is just a snapshot internal version of a project that we're making. And then we have these two fields here. So these mean that I am going to compile against JDK 21 and I'm intending to deploy this against JDK 21. And then we have the encoding of the source files, which UTF-8 is the standard encoding we use here. And the POM file can actually get quite large in complex Maven projects, but for today, we're just gonna keep the POM nice and simple. So let's get back to the error here. So could not transfer artifact, and then some really long thing that is like, what is going on here? Okay, so if you encounter errors like this, the first thing you wanna do is you wanna make sure that your Maven installation on your machine is correct. So let's go ahead and open up a terminal. Make this a little bit bigger. And to check your Maven installation, all you have to do is do a maven-v. And we have a problem here. We can see that PowerShell doesn't even know what the Maven executable is. So just because we set up a Maven project in IntelliJ doesn't mean that Maven's gonna work right away. Maven is a software tool just like other tools we use, so that means we need to install it first. So there are a few ways to install it. If you are on something like Linux or Mac, you could use a package manager like apt or homebrew. Similarly, you could use Chocolaty on Windows or something like that, but instead what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna walk through the installation as shown on their website. So now that we're back at Maven's website, if we click on this download button, we can see here that we have a few different options to download. So in my case, since I'm running on Windows, I'm gonna download the zip right here. And then here in my case, I unzipped it into my user folder. And then if I open it up here, then I have this bin directory. And in the bin directory, I have the actual Maven executable. So now what you'd wanna do is you'd want to include this path here. You'd want to add this into your path environment variable, which there are multiple ways you do that depending on which operating system you'd use. And once you've added that, then you should be able to open a terminal window again and execute the mvn-v command. So opening a new shell, since I did update the environment variables, let's try again. All right, much better. So now I'm running Apache Maven 3.9.6, and I've got the Maven home here. And one thing you want to check is that your Java version matches the version that you're trying to compile against. If it doesn't, then you're going to get some cryptic errors about the Maven compiler plugin not supporting your version. So in my case, it says version 21, which all looks good. If this path doesn't all match, then you're going to want to look at your Java home environment variable, and you're going to want to look at your Java executable path on your path environment variable. So now that I've got Maven installed, let's go ahead and make sure everything looks good. If you run Maven validate, we get a build success here. So basically what the Maven validate command does is it makes sure that the project you're in has a valid POM and has a valid structure to it. So it's reading the POM XML, and then it says, yes, looks good. And it includes how long it took and the time at which it finished. So after you've validated that your project structure looks good, the next thing you might want to do is compile it. And likewise, we get another build success here. Cool. So this prints out a fair amount of information. So what it's doing is the first thing is that it makes sure that you've got a Maven project to compile against. And then it uses this compiler. So compiler 3.11.0. So that's the Maven compiler plugin version 3.11.0. And then it's running the compile command. Changes detected, recompiling, compiling one source file with Java C with target of 21. And it built successfully. So if I were to run the compile command again, the main difference we'll see here is that the compiler plugin says nothing to compile, all classes are up to date. So basically what'll happen is it'll only compile the changes that are actually there. And if there are no changes, it's not going to compile anything. Let's say that you want to clear out any changes that you may have had and you want to recompile everything. You can do that with a Maven clean. And what Maven clean is going to do is it's going to delete this target directory. So target is where the generated class files and any sort of jar files you generate, that's where all of that goes. So if I minimize this window here for a second and I open up the project view, if I were to compile this within IntelliJ using the build hammer here, what we'll notice is that the target directory over here is going to show up as well. All right, now that target directory showed up, we can see we have classes and generated sources within here. And then we can see here when we open up the classes that we have our package, and then we have our generated main class file here. Believe me, it looks like there are a lot of unnecessary directories in here to meet this project structure, but as your projects get bigger and bigger, this is well worth it. So we spent a lot of time actually compiling. What if we run the code? So just like you would always in IntelliJ, you can run the code via this little green arrow, and we do get the typical hello world. But let's say that we want to run it from the terminal. So how you can do that is you need to be able to generate an executable. So compiling generates all the class files, and now you need to package everything up. So you can do a Maven package. And what that'll do is it will compile your code and then it will package it into a jar file within the target directory. One thing that's important is that I could just as easily write compile package, but that's redundant because when you ask Maven to package, it implicitly does a compile first. So most people just omit that. All right, now that the package command is done, let's see what all it did. Interesting. So I'm getting a lot of new things downloaded. So this Surefire plugin here, this is what is used for Maven testing. The package goal of Maven also does a test phase. So it wants to make sure that you've got all of Maven's test plugins available, even though we don't have any tests we're going to run. So that's why all of these downloads are happening. And that should only have to happen once, because what's going to happen is it's going to put all these downloaded artifacts into what's called your local Maven repository. And the local Maven repository is where you can install your own artifacts, or it's where you can cache artifacts that are dependencies for your project. So everything that's in here is for the test goal. If I go a little higher, I can see the compile goal happening as well. And then if I keep going higher, I can see that the validate goal would have happened up here at the very beginning. So the big thing that the package goal is doing is it's building our jar file. So this is our executable that you can then distribute to other people, and they could include it as a dependency within their code. So now that Maven generated this jar file for me, how do I actually run my code? Well, to do that, you can run java-cp, which is the class path, and it's going to exist here. So the class path is basically your jar file. And then now what you want to do is you want to give the fully qualified name of the class that contains your main method within it. And we can see that we get our hello world. So if you're anything like me, the question that's probably weighing over your head right now is, why should I care about using Maven? It seems like it's a lot of work. Seems like it's really heavy. Seems like I have all of these plugins I need to download. Seems like there's all this extra work just to get a very basic Hello World program working. And you're not wrong on a lot of that for a really basic application. But what I would say is that for anything of substance in a Java application, you're really gonna need something that makes your build process, your dependency management, and your deployment process much more streamlined. And tools like Maven are fantastic for that. Picture here, instead of a single main class, I've got 100 classes. Picture that I've got 50 unit tests, or maybe I have 3 or 4 dependent libraries and I need to keep changing the versions all the time. A lot of those things get a lot simpler when you have a tool like Maven on your side to help you out. When you're building a really simple application, yeah, there's not a lot of benefit. But as soon as your application really starts scaling, you really need to put in some time into infrastructure. And Maven is a great investment into your project's infrastructure. The other thing I'll add is that Maven is used extensively in the Java community. So out of all the Java devs that I know, I'd say at least 2 out of 3, probably more like 3 out of 4, use Maven on the day-to-day in their projects. So everyone's using it. It's a really good tool to be able to learn, and for good reason. So I'd recommend that you get into it today, read the documentation, start playing around with some of your own projects. If you enjoyed today's video, please do smash that like button. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.